A very pleasant morning to all my dear children. Welcome back to English online class of Sri Govindam Public School, Guruvayur. How are you all doing, children? You all are doing well, right? Yes. Okay, children, let's begin our today's session. Today, let's deal with lesson 10, verbs. Verbs, very easy topic, right? Yes, we all know what are verbs. So, what are verbs, children? Verbs are one of the 8 parts of speech. Now, tell me which are the 8 parts of speech. I know you all know which are the 8 parts of speech. Okay, try to say it along with me, okay? They are nouns, pronouns, verbs, adverbs, adjectives, prepositions, conjunctions, and the last one, interjections. So, these are the 8 parts of speech. Now, let's look at some examples, okay? From the examples, we will define what are verbs. The very first example, Vaiga bought a laptop yesterday. They play football in the afternoon. My father is an engineer. Shreya is a good singer. They are happy. Salman has a friend, George. The very first example, it says about an action, right? Action done by a person called Vaiga. Okay, so here, Vaiga is a subject. We call Vaiga the subject, okay? So, the sentence talk about Vaiga. That's why Vaiga is a subject. Who or what we are talking about becomes a subject of that sentence. So, Vaiga is a subject. And what is Vaiga doing? What is the subject doing in that sentence? She bought a laptop yesterday. Bought. Okay? Bought is the past tense of buy. So, here which is the action word, children? What is the action done by Vaiga? She bought. Bought is the action. So, bought is the action word or the verb in that sentence. In short, we can say verbs are action words. So, verbs are not only action words. It has some other definitions. Let's see other definitions also. In the second example, they play football in the afternoon. Here, which is the action word, children? Play. Okay. And they is a subject. Okay. What is they doing? They are playing football, right? So, play is a verb in that sentence. That is the action word. Now, let's move on to the third example. My father is an engineer. So, here, can you find an action word? No, right? Here, the only verb is. And in the fourth sentence, Shreya is a good singer. Again, in this fourth sentence, the verb is. Okay? Now, let's move on to the fifth one. They are happy. In this word, again, there's no action word. Are is the verb. Okay? They are not doing any action. It is there. We are here describing about their state of being. How they are. Okay? So, in the third and fourth sentence, in the both these sentences, the verb is. And here, is tells us, or the verbs tells us what someone is. Okay? What someone is or something is. Now, let's see the last two examples. Salman has a friend, George. Here, which is the verb, children? Has. Has is a verb. There are no action words, okay? Has is not actually an action word, okay? Has is a verb in that sentence. Now, what do you mean by has in that sentence, children? Has, we told has is a verb. What is the function performed by or done by has in that sentence? Here, has means possess or owns, okay? It means Salman has a friend. He has his own friend, that is George. Now, he has a car. Again, in the sentence, has is a verb. Okay. And now, what do you mean by he has a car? Means he owns a car. So, let's see what are verbs once more. Verbs are used to denote an action. It tells us what someone or something does. Okay. The action done by them. The verb also tells us the condition of the subject. What someone or something is. Okay. Now, the verbs also tells us or it denotes what someone or something possesses or owns. So, I hope you understood what are the usages of verbs. Verbs are divided into two based on their function, okay? Based on their function and nature. And they are main verbs and auxiliary verbs. The other name for auxiliary verbs is helping verbs. Now, let's see what is a main verb, okay? Main verbs are those verbs which tells us the actual action performed by the subject. They can be used by themselves in a sentence. Now, what do you mean by that? It means main verbs are those verbs which can express its meaning independently. Okay? And tells us what the subject does, feels, or is. the main verbs, they may not depend on other verbs to express its meaning. That's why it's said they can be used by themselves in a sentence. Okay. For example, the nightingale sings sweetly. Here, which is a word, children, that denotes verb? It is sings. Okay. Sings is a verb in this sentence. Means it denotes an action in this sentence. Okay. The next one. Tina bakes delicious cakes. Now here, which is action word or which is verb? It is bakes. Okay. Now always the verbs will not denote an action. So here in these two sentences, it denotes action. And there is only one verb in this sentence. The primary verb, that is a main verb. Okay. Sings and bakes. Now let's see what's an auxiliary verb. The other name for auxiliary verb is helping verb. So from the name itself, you understood what is the function of the helping verb or auxiliary verb, isn't it? Yes. So it is used. These auxiliaries are used before the main verb to form the tense and also to denote the person and number of the subjects. So it helps the main verb to form the tense. Auxiliary verb or helping verb is used before the main verb to form the tense and also to denote the person and number of the subjects. Let's see with examples. Okay, let's see what is a primary auxiliary first. Auxiliary verbs or helping verbs are again divided into two. They are called primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Right now, we'll deal only with primary auxiliaries. We'll deal with modal auxiliaries in our next class. Okay, let's see which are the primary auxiliaries. They are the be forms of the verb, have forms of the verb, and do forms of the verb. Which are the be forms of the verb? Is, am, are, was, and were. Now, have forms of the verb? Have, has, and had. Do forms of the verb? Do, does, and did. So, these are the primary auxiliaries. Now, let's see all these primary auxiliaries in detail. The first one, is. Is is used with singular subjects. For example, Dharmik is a good boy. He is a hardworking student. So, Dharmik is a single person, right? So, with singular subjects, I can use is, okay? Now, next, let's move on to am. Am is used with I. For example, I am Ramya. I am a teacher, okay? So, am is used with I. Next, are. Are is used with plural subjects. For example, cows are domestic animals. Cows. There are more than one cow, right? So, we used are. We are Indians. We is a plural subject. So, that's why I used are. You are good children. You. You again is a plural subject. So, I used are. So, I hope you understood is, am and are. Now, next was and were. Was is a past form. Okay. For example, I was a student of Sri Kerala Varma College. I was a student. So, it says that or it states that I am no more a student. Right. So, I was in the past form. Okay. It is the past form. Now, where. Where is again the past form. So, where is used with plural subjects and was is used with singular subjects.